coming real, it's the next episode. Finally, it's here. God, I've been waiting for this. Yes. Okay, so I've got your attention for at least 5 minutes. This is just a piece of crap. It ain't gonna make your batteries bigger. At times I wanna share other things I've learned on the internet. It's difficult to fit it into an episode where I'm making things. And the whole purpose of making smaller shows like this is that I can share that knowledge with you guys. And there has been a lot of things that I've wanted to include in the videos, but it's just not being appropriate or doesn't fit in with what is being aired at that time. So I'm hoping there's going to be a few small episodes like this that I can produce within a five to 10 minute category that you guys can quickly watch while you're on the tube or the train or wherever you're going. I want to begin this first episode by talking about a video I saw on YouTube. And what I saw didn't make for good viewing because it kind of had the policy makers completely denying what was going on in the world. And what we had was Mr. DiCaprio traveling the globe and graphically showing exactly what was happening with the environment and with our home that we live in. The other week, before watching this documentary, I was listening to the BBC Radio 4, which we have in this country, and it was a science show for 1 hour, and I tend to listen to stuff like that and it helps me sleep at night. Not that it's boring. There's one statement that just basically woke me up. In the first time in recorded history, we have experienced 400 parts per million in the levels of CO2. What does 400 ppm mean? If you look at the last time we had 400 ppm, was some 7 million years ago. And again, 7 million years ago, well, that still doesn't make any sense to me. If I said to you 50 years ago, that sounds like a long time ago. 7 million years, you couldn't even comprehend what 7 million years is. So let me explain it with this chart here. This is the evolution of man. And if you go along here, right here, this is 7 million years away. Industrial revolution that we've had on this planet has been about 100, 150 years, which is where we've been burning coal, oil, and that gap of 100, 150 years is about here. I don't know if you can see it, just about there. Let me zoom in so you can see, since 25 million years life has been on this planet, this here is 150 years. Okay, 7 million to 150 years ago, CO2 levels were at a level that were tolerable. In the 150 years that mankind has industrialized everything, in that period, CO2 has risen back to this point here. Now, the key thing here is not to get too disheartened. Yes, we've ruining the planet. Yes, CO2 our levels up, 400 ppm and rising. Now, there is a way that we can save ourselves, and that is already underway. The first thing that we have to do is the people that make these policies, we need to approach these people and write to them and say, look, enough is enough. Introduce the carbon tax, reduce other taxes and bring that one in play. We, as people who are responsible for this planet for the next generation, need to change our lifestyles and make it in a way that it reduces our carbon footprint. Some of us who are watching these type of videos are trying to do this not only for reducing our carbon footprint, but is also to reduce our overheads. Let's be honest. We don't want to give utility companies hundreds and thousands of pounds a year for providing us with electricity. We're trying to be self-sufficient, and that's the whole point of 18650 is that it's energy storage. You see, let me explain something. As an engineer, we just love solving problems. It doesn't have to be a mechanical or an electrical or whatever it has to be. The way that an engineer's brain is wired up is that we think about a problem in an analytical manner, and then we try to come up with solutions that best fit that scenario with the technology that we have today. And that's why I introduced this at the beginning of the video, because I wanted to talk about the future and how we can get ourselves out of this rut that we're forever digging ourselves into. I'm forever the optimist. There are a fair few other optimists out there, and it will take engineers and scientists to come up with the solution that will help this planet recover from its dependency on fossil fuel. Without trying to get political about anything, and I have no political gain from making this video, I want to talk about the science and engineering of where we are going in the future with these type of new batteries. If there's any technology or any breakthroughs regarding energy storage or 18650 or lithium ion based batteries, put it into the comments section. I'd love to read up on it. And then if it's something that is worth sharing, then I think it's worth making an episode about. And as always, it's your feedback that you leave that helps this channel what you want it to become tomorrow. Go.